Good afternoon, everyone. This is Avneet, and I've done my bachelor's from Vivekananda Institute of Professional Studies, and done my master's from GGSIPU, main campus, Dwarka. Today, I'll be taking up here a presentation on social media planning and strategy. Well, starting off with social media, with the advent of the internet world, we have got through the new media. While in 14th century, we started media with Gutenberg's printing press. While now, as the time moved on, we have transformed to a new world with the new media. New media is extension of all the medias on the web form, and it's like encompasses context, audios, videos, and pictures in digital form. So here's the definition on what is social media. It's an umbrella term that defines various activities and integrates technology wherein the interaction is on the basis of content, pictures, audio, as well as video. Like for example, audio or video we can have as YouTube as the option. Pictures is a social media like Facebook, Instagram. And words could be memes, blogs, etc. Social media is also the conversation supported by online tools. While social media is a promotional channel through which we can disseminate content and information, it has long-term return on effects. Like if we are indulging into social media, if any brand is indulging into social media, it has to choose which all platforms it need to choose to promote its brand, keeping in mind the various market segments. And likewise, with certain time effect, they'll be able to judge on what on return they have.
Okay, Avneet, tell me one thing, that you're talking about social media, right? So what do you think for students? I mean, as a student, what aspects of social media are useful for them? Like as a student, how can they benefit them? I mean, apart from Facebooking and all the normal
I
things.
I believe blogging is one of the best tools of social media that students, like if I have some particular knowledge regarding a book or a novel, I can review it myself on my blog.
Okay.
How can journalism students use social media for their future prospect or their career?
For a journalism student, it would be great to, like, they can have their own website, create their own website, whether they are into advertising, PR, like anything, be it be any form of traditional media.
Basically, you're talking about that it is blogging only that they should be doing. Right.
Not just blogging. Blogging is just one aspect of social media that can be useful for students.
Mm-hmm.
While there are other forms as well, like you can, if someone has an interest in film and television production, they can make small documentary movies and mm-hmm. promote it through their YouTube channels.
Mm-hmm.
Likewise, it's as per their interest, what all areas of interest they hold. According to that, they can use social media as a platform to spread their message, spread their content among audiences, and achieve review what they have done. Like on social media, they'll be getting good comments as well, bad criticism as well. So,
okay, tell me one thing. See, you must have seen that the writing and, you know, the content has changed quite a bit, right? say 10 years back it was something else, now it is something else. So can you differentiate between the two? How, what are the changes that you can see in the content?
Earlier the content was particularly like more focusing on the language and the grammatical aspect. Now what is about, what the what holds the importance of the message? Message is what is main focus right now. It doesn't matter that how you're disseminating that message. It just matters that the way you're disseminating your message. Like that should be more catchy to the people so that they can retain it for a long period of time.
Okay.
Like earlier that was in written form. While we are reading so many things in a day, we might lose something out there, but through the advent of social media, we get new ways through which we can make our content catchy and disseminate in a ripple form.
So you're trying to say the shelf life of a news or something that has increased?
Definitely.
Okay.
Just wrap it up please quickly, the presentation.
Can
we see the other slides?
Sure. Should I move on without speaking on anything?
If you just can elaborate on SEOs and how can be and how can they be beneficial for the students?
You know what SEO?
For social social search engine optimization.
How it works?
It's like the frequency of popularity that a domain holds in like.
Okay.
For a brand, if we talk about how can a brand use social media, so it can be an effective way to provide customer service through their online 24/7 helpline, either through chat formats or something like that. Even for the product feedback and
it's okay, you can go.
Even for the product feedback and services, customers can use social media as a base to transfer. While when we come for planning social media strategy, what comes foremostly is pre-planning. Every brand, let's for take an example of Nykaa, that's a cosmetic online cosmetic brand. That sells its products online. So there is like the brand needs to pre-plan what it needs to achieve so that where it's standing right now, it could in later coming years could just make out where it has reached over the time.
Avneet, one thing I have to share with you, are you not really comfortable right now? Are you comfortable?
Yes, yes.
Or there is a communication skills problem?
No, I'm comfortable.
Sure.
Yeah.
Please proceed.
After planning comes the listen to the conversation. Listen to the conversation is like what all is going in the marketplace. Like what all are your competitors into? What are the new ethics and laws that are coming up with passage of time? Then create your target profile. Target profile is choosing your target audience. Target audience can be like on market segmentation on the basis of demographics, on the basis of geographical area, on psychographical perspectives and on behavioral perspectives. On demographics, what areas are considered are age, gender, family size, social class and income, while on geographical areas, the population, the region and the climate all are considered. Psychographics includes the interests and the opinions of the customers, and behavior is the loyalty and the benefits that the brand would be benefiting their customers with. Next step comes the specific goals that a brand needs to maintain.
Can you wrap it up quickly, please, Avneet? which are just, we can gradually, like, you can change the slide if we see anything, we'll ask. We can go further, please.
This setting specific goals. A brand need to set up specific goals to include in its social media planning. It needs to be aware of the what all is happening in the market. Like if we talk about the same brand Nykaa, if there are some laws related to that the cosmetic
what
product.
What is CRM?
It's customer relationship management. Like if the brand Nykaa, there are new policies like the cosmetics shouldn't be made of by harming the animals. They should not be animal tested. So they should be brand should be aware of such policies so that they don't indulge into something that causes them into trouble or.
Using these content only. Suppose you are launching a new product.
Okay.
If this is a strategy of your content. So using the same content that you are right now in front, displaying in front of us, how you will strategize this content to you know, organize one workshop, or how you will use these content to display the product, because it's a new one, nobody knows about it. So how you will use the social media as a tool to upgrade advertising?
I'll be picking up a cosmetic brand, mm-hmm. brand.
Mm-hmm.
Let's say for that matter, Body Shop.
Mm-hmm.
Though it's a known one,
mm-hmm.
but still. For example, if Body Shop is coming up with its wide range of cosmetic products, they'll need to plan something first of all to get into the market.
No, using the social media tools, how you will strategize your plan?
What all channels?
Maybe, yeah,
what
maybe
all
it
channels?
Is an existing product or maybe it is a new one. Seldom matters. But using these tools without the offline advertisements, how you will use this social media as an advertising tool?
Like on Facebook, I need to mention the different channels.
Yeah, maybe Facebook, maybe Twitter, maybe YouTube, maybe whatever so.
Like if we choose Facebook as a platform, we can mention about what all are the upcoming products, what are their benefits. We can launch these schemes, product offers, and to make it something interesting and involve the audiences, which is the foremost aspect. What needs to be done is that something should be involving, some activity or event should be organized that should involve masses so that they can get to know about the product in huge numbers.
Okay, wrap it up.
Should I?
Wrap it. Conclude it if you want.
So basically, social media can be used like Facebook can be used as a platform. Like similarly, Instagram, these days we have those option of live videos. We can use that live videos demonstrating our some product, that how can that be used and how what are its benefits of using that. All that can be shown to the customers, because while you go live, there are a lot number of people that indulge to your